गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एचपीसीसी। इन एचपीसीसी फर्स्ट पार्ट इन सीसी एंड इन सीसी चैप्टर नंबर टू। चैप्टर नंबर वन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन, चैप्टर नंबर टू। नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज इफेक्टिव लेटर राइटिंग। Effective letter writing and its various styles and its various style. चैप्टर नंबर टू। इन चैप्टर नंबर टू 2.1 इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट। इन इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट 6th or 7th लाइन, ओके वंस आई एम रीडिंग। इन द प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ दिस अबाउट इफेक्टिव लेटर राइटिंग एंड इट्स वेरियस स्टाइल्स। First 2.1 introduction part. In the present age of internet, effective communication skills play a vital role in expanding business. Means communication also, means effective communication also play an important role in expanding business. Means besides we have already studied that finance is important, then technical knowledge is important, but beside all these things, effective communication, effective communication is also important for expansion of business or effective communication play an important role in the expansion of business. So in the present age of internet, effective communication skills plays a vital means important role in expanding business, individual and professional success. Modern methods and means of communication have almost diminished, the diminished means complete finished, the boundaries of place and time. Place and time here means earlier in traditional method of communication we have to send letter and it takes lots of time, but nowadays through telephone, through internet process, within a few seconds we can transmit our communication, our message from one place to another place or any corner of the world. So that is written here that modern methods and means of communication have almost diminished the boundaries of place and time. Different class in the society look for various means of communication to stay connected constantly with one another and have accepted various means of communication. Means whatever methods and means of communications are important for us, we always try to remain in touch with such type of communication, or in simple language we are adopting such type of communications which makes our life, which makes our business important. Modern methods of communication are speedy, effective, economical and simpler, so are widely accepted and popular. So what is the characteristics of modern methods of communication? For second point, modern method of communication are speedy, effective, economical and simpler. keeping in mind the attitude, nature, training, mental makeup and circumstances of people of India, we evaluate the methods of communication present time. We observe that people of our country in the recent age largely rely means depend on letter writing for business and official matters. So of course the form of letter writing has changed, but its importance has not decreased. Means importance of letter remains the same. It helps in increasing or expansion of the business. It establish social relation between two individuals or between two business units, but only methods of communication has been changed. Now we have adopted new modern methods like mobile, then internet. With the help of internet we are able to send letter, telex, fax. These are the different modes of, then TV also, radio. These are the effective methods of communication, modern methods of communication. So here the form of last sentence, the form of letter writing, form of letter writing has changed. But its importance, has not decreased. Means importance of communication, letter writing is still the same, has not decreased. So these are the important point in 2.1. First topic, introduction. That effective letter or effective communication is also important, or it plays a vital role, key role for the expansion of business, for the increasing the personality of individual, for establishing social relation. Modern methods of communication are speedy, effective, economical and simpler. And the form of letter writing only. What is the difference between traditional methods of communication and modern methods of communication? That only form of letter writing, means style of writing letter, has changed, but its importance is still the same, means does not decrease. This is about introduction part. Second one is 2.2, history of letter writing is deleted from your course. Now third one is 2.3. That is characteristics of letter writing. So what should be the feature when we are writing a letter nowadays? From means letter written by one business unit to other business unit, or one party to other business unit, or business unit to parties. Parties means here customers, shareholders, debentures. So what should be the features, characteristics or nature of letter writing? This is 2.3. Once again, 2.1 introduction part we have done. Then 2.2 is deleted from the course. Now characteristics of letter writing 2.3. Characteristics of letter writing. So direct come to page number 8. Following points may be enumerated, means taken as characteristics or features of letter writing. First point, total 8 points are given, so any 6 points you have to do. First, it is simple and reasonable method of communication. Means it should be simple and reasonable method of communication. सेकेंड पॉइंट एनी सिक्स पॉइंट्स और फिर ओन चॉइस यू कैन टेक. इट हैज नो बाउंड्रीज. इट हैज नो बाउंड्रीज ऑफ प्लेस एंड टाइम. It has no boundaries of place and time. Third important point, it is taken as an evidence if letter is in the written form. Or in simple language, it is taken as an evidence. It is taken as an evidence in future. Fourth point, it is a link between or it establish a relation between writer of the letter and its receiver. Next, fifth, the writing of letter establish an image of the firm or institution. And sixth, one more point. Letters are easily sent and received. So here 6 points I have taken as characteristics of letter writing. First one is it should be simple and reasonable methods of communication, means according to situation, according to work style, we should adopt the modern methods of communication. Means wherever email message is required, we should send message through email. Wherever text message is required, wherever oral communication is also required, then it has no boundaries of place and time. I have already told you that modern methods of communication has removed the boundaries of place and time. Means within a few seconds we can transmit message from one corner to another corner of the world. Then it is taken as an evidence in future, in any important matter, in any important discussion, we can take it as an evidence. And it is a link between the writer, means sender of the letter, and its receiver. It establishes a relation. Either relation may be means social relation or business relation, but it establishes a relation between the sender of the letter and its receiver. Next, the writing of letter establishes an image of the firm or institution towards third party. In the eyes of third party, through letter writing, business units can establish a good reputation towards stakeholder. And another last point, letters are easily sent and received. So these are the characteristics of letter writing. Then 2.4, types of letter writing. Now next one is types of letter writing, 2.4. Total there are two types or two methods of writing letter. One is formal and informal. Formal letters and informal letters. Now formal letters. Formal letters is also of two types. One is business letter means in this topic there is nothing to explain, only for formality I am completing this chapter. Business letters. Another one is official letter. Now what is business letter definition and what is official letters? Business letters, letters written with the purpose, here I am writing business letter, business letters definition, letters written with the purpose of advertising and expanding business. Letters, for example, letters of inquiry, letters of orders, letter of agency, etc. So letters written with the purpose of advertising and expanding business. Expanding business means when written communication take place between two business parties, but for advertising or for expanding business. Expanding business means, for example, we are writing letter to another, one business unit is writing letter to another business unit, for they are giving order of huge order they are giving of various types of goods, that is called expanding business. Advertising, one business units are furnishing, supplying their quotation means price list with picture of products to various companies so that they can give order to them. Such type of letters they are writing with the purpose of advertising and expanding business, then such letters are called business letters. Then examples are given, letter of inquiry, these are examples. Letter of inquiry means we are putting questions, various types of questions we are asking from other business units about their products, means which type of products they are selling, what is the price, then if they are giving credit or not, means goods they are selling on credit or not. So such type of inquiry we are taking from business units in the form of letter. So letter of inquiry. So these are the example of business letter, letter of inquiry. Next, letter of order. After inquiry, we can give order for supply of such goods, letter of order. For this purpose, we are writing letter, letter of order, and letter of agency. Means it has two part, letter of agency. One, the business units or the institution which want to act as an agency for other business unit. So they are writing letter to the main manufacturers that we are ready or we are interested in establishing or appointing as an agent of your product. The letter of agency. So these are business letter. On the other side, official letters. Second part, official letters. Now what is the meaning of official letters? Letter written to the institution means we are writing letter to particular department regarding administrative matters. Means for some, in order to solve our problem, we are writing letters to different institution like water department, like BSNL means telephone department. The different institution we are writing letter in order to solve our administrative problems. So here, letters written to the institution regarding administrative matters. Regarding administrative matters. For example, applications we are writing. For example, applications we are writing letter to bank in order to issue checkbook, in order to open account, in order to stop payment of check. Different types of application we are writing to bank. Letters regarding ration card. Letters regarding ration card. Water problems, etc. It means formal letter has two part, business letter and official letter. Business letter is only written by one business unit to other business unit, or business unit to customer, or customer to business unit. But here, in case of official letter, either it is business unit or individual, any person can write letter to any agency, any institution for solving their problems. For example, applications, different types of application for different purpose, we are writing letter to bank, we are writing letter regarding ration card. Any individual can apply for ration card, and for this purpose they need to write letter, but in the prescribed format. Proper style is to be used for writing letter, that's why it is called official letters. And water problems, whenever any person or business unit has problem, means official letter is not necessary that official letter is only written by business unit. It can be written by any person, but they are writing letters to a particular institution in order to solve their problems. And next one is informal letters. We all know informal letters are written by one individual to another individual. They have, in order to establish relation, or if they have relation, for various purpose, like letter of greeting. Letter of greeting means, for example, if any of your relative has passed 10th board with good marks, you are writing letter of congratulations. So letter of greeting. These are the examples of informal letter. Anyway, we can write letter. Here, in case of informal letter, we are not required to follow a prescribed format, a style. Anyway, we can write letter of greetings, condolence. Condolence, then congratulations, and invitation. So for this purpose we are writing letter, we are writing informal letter, etc. So types of letters, once again, formal letters, because formal letters has two parts, business letters and official letter. Both business letters and official letters must be written in a prescribed format, which we must adopt a style. Format should be in a style, in such a style that it will attract, it will establish the image of the business unit. Official letter, when we are writing letter to a particular institution in for solving any or regarding any administrative work. And informal letter, second part, here we are not required to follow any prescribed format in order to write a letter to anybody else. These types of letter writing. Now next topic, 2.5. Meaning of business letter. This 2.5. Is the last topic of this chapter. After that, 2.6, 2.7, 2.8, 2.9. All topics are deleted from the course. 2.5, the meaning of business letter. The meaning of business letter. When there is an exchange, when there is an exchange of information between an individual one individual and other between two institutions, or between an individual, or between an individual and institution. Letter writing is known as correspondence. So this is the first point regarding definition of correspondence. So what is correspondence? So whenever there is an exchange of information, means informations are transmitted from one individual to another individual, or from one business unit to other business unit, or from one business unit to individual, or individual to business unit, through letter writing, means in written form, then such a communication in written form is called correspondence. Second point, when this correspondence when this correspondence is carried out, for business purpose, then it is called business correspondence. And examples of business correspondence we have already done. Examples: letter of inquiry, letter of order, etc. are the examples of business correspondence. So this is the last topic. After that, 2.6, 2.7 till 2.9, all are deleted from the course. Now this chapter is completed.